Give me your name, your position, and how long you've worked here.
My name is Chris Fitzgerald. I'm a personal trainer, and I've been here for 4.5 years.
My name is Cindy Rankin, and I've been here for 28 years. Next month, I'll be 29.
Hi, my name is Lisa Walton. I've been with the Claremont Club for 4 years, and I work in the membership sales department.
My name is Jason Smoot, and I've been part of the Claremont Club and the Be Perfect Foundation for the last 5 years, and I've been working here within the Children's Center for the past 4 years.
My name is Diana O'Brien. My position is the racquetball director here at the Claremont Club, and I've been a member for 33 years and worked here for 16.
My name is Lindsay Robertson. I've been here for almost 4 years, and I went from front desk up to accounts receivable now.
Don Cushing. I'm a maintenance engineer. That's what they call it. And I've been here 4 years.
My name is Robin Gomez. I am the evening and weekend supervisor of our childcare department here at the club. I am also our science camp instructor during our summer camps. And I started at the club in the summer of 2011. So I'm going on my 6th year.
Okay, my name is Jennifer Altry. I've been at the Claremont Club for 14 years and I am a swim coach.
How would you compare working here specifically from the employee atmosphere to other places? What's it like at other gyms versus here?
Well, there's a heightened level of camaraderie at the Claremont Club. I've really developed a lot of good friendships, and I genuinely care about my coworkers, and I know they care about me, and you can't really find that anywhere else.
Oh, it's great. I've made friends for life. I've met so many great people here that I will forever cherish, for sure.
You know, everybody, I think, that works here does so because they want to work here. They want to help people. We support each other, and I see it like within the front desk, we've got a good group, and within the other departments too. You know, we want to be team players, and I feel like we have that here. Everybody is a team player and helps everybody else out however we can.
It does feel like a family, and I've made quite a few good friends here. So it's got a neat social aspect as well as the part of working. And the people I work with, we really feel like a team. We work together to accomplish things. So that's kind of unique.
Just the comfort zone that I feel. I have a lot of close friends, and I enjoy everybody that works here that have come and gone, and I've made a lot of new friends. And in the racquetball world, squash and handball people, we have parties, we do a lot of extra things besides just teaching and playing racquetball.
I think everyone is enjoying being here. We enjoy what we do, and it's a community. We get to know our employees make bigger connections with the members, and it's just a happy place to be.
You know what, when you walk in the door at the Claremont Club, everyone who works here has a smile, is ready to greet you. Everybody knows everybody, and it really does feel like a family. It's fun to come to work and catch up with people, and I really enjoy it.
Never really feels like I'm coming to work. I'm always like looking forward to coming here, interacting with the kids, catching up with some of my coworkers on how their week was going. It's never like a drag or, you know, it's never a pain in the neck to come here, and I always look forward to it. So when you get paid for that, and when work doesn't feel like work, then that's the most important thing. You're actually doing what you like to do.
Just the feeling. It's just a feeling of family. So whether you're a member, whether you're an employee, whether you're a kid, you're family, you know. A lot of the kids who come in the club, especially like our pet Pete's kids, Zane and Malik, Yosef, I almost see them as my own kids. Some of our fellow employee kids, Hayden Vanderhoof, I love him, Nika, Rena, I mean, and then just a lot of the member kids, the Cheatwoods, there's just so many kids here that I just like, I feel like they're my kids, you know? So we're like family, whether you're, you know, with the other staff too and with everybody.
Hi, my name is Roya Pearsall and I am a Pilates instructor, group exercise instructor, cycling, bar, Zumba, and I've worked here about 9 years.
I'm Kurt, I'm an MOD and I've worked here for 6.5 years.
My name is Jojo Lavalsi, I'm a personal trainer. I've been working at the Claremont Club for 11 years.
My name is Kathy and I am the childcare supervisor and I've been here almost 11 years.
My name is Juana Rodriguez. I've been here for 13 years, almost 14. I work as a receptionist in Project Walk.
My name is Prem Christian. I am a childcare lead and I've worked here since 2014.
My name is Tracy Granberry. I've worked at the club for almost 20 years and I am the club's registered dietitian.
Okay, my name is Maribel Ramirez and my position is ladies locker room. And I have Monday and Tuesday working on laundry also.
Cool.
And
thank you for that.
I've been working here almost 2 years.
This is going to be a really open question. What do you get out of it?
Seeing people motivated by what I do motivates me to work harder. And if I can get one person to work a little harder for even 5 minutes or 1 minute in a class or in my Pilates sessions, then it's worth it for me.
You know, like I actually develop friendship, like as you know, every family join in and I take care of their kids. And I think that's the best part of my job. And to see them grow, it's the best part of my job. It's fun to watch them grow.
I get a lot of satisfaction from working with all different types of people, athletes and midlife folks and older adults. And so I think when I hear, you know, things like people are able to get on and off the floor without help because they've been strength training, or I have an 85-year-old lady that I work with and she can do lying down pullovers with a 25-pound dumbbell, it just makes my job all the more worth it. I feel like I'm contributing to getting people healthy and fit.
How would you describe it? I feel really, really satisfied when I see them smile at me or, you know, be nice to me.
What I get out of working with them, it's just a full heart, just really just loving and caring for the kids. I enjoy just hanging around. I enjoy just having fun with the kids. I think having the kids let loose and just be themselves and have fun is just one of the best ways a kid can just express themselves, and I really do enjoy when kids are being themselves.
Well, at the club, there's a huge demographic of all kinds of different people, and to be able to interact with all those people from different careers, different nationalities, different faiths, different everything, and you get to know them pretty affluently. And it exposes you to just a lot of what's out there, and you get to know people on a personal basis, and it's really, really neat.
It's an inspiration every day. It's like you are being fueled with energy, with enthusiasm, with the spirit of just living every day. The clients are amazing, not only because they're dealing with their illnesses and physical impairments, but the spirits that they have to come and just work on their daily, you know, routines, and they still come with such a great attitude. That's, to me, that's amazing.
My name is Darren Richer. I've worked here for almost 15 years now, and I am a tennis pro here at the Claremont Club.
I'm Sarah. I've worked in childcare for 5 years.
My name is Tyler Houck. I am a swim coach and I've been here for 7 years.
I started here as an independent 25 years ago, and I'm a tennis pro at the Claremont Club.
My name is Shireen Beckett. I've been here since December of 2016 as an indoor cycling instructor, but I've been a member for a long, long time at the Claremont Club.
My name's Joe. I work in maintenance and I'm an MOD, and I've been here about year and a half, I would say.
I am Diane Clouston and I work in the salon. I've been here 10.5 years now.
My name is Lisa Copenhaver. I'm the food and beverage director for the Claremont Club. And as of February 4th, I have been here, wow, 8 years.
What inspires you to come here and dedicate 8 hours to a day to dealing with kids and to dealing with parents and dealing with other workers? What inspires you to do that?
Making a difference in the kids' lives and seeing it where parents are appreciative. Earlier today, I had a little boy run up to me and give me a hug where the mom was in tears because it was just so nice for her to see her son so excited to see me and to be at the Claremont Club. That's really special to me to know, even if it's just helping a kid get to the bathroom or making sure they're eating their snack at a certain time and just taking that stress off from the parents is great.
We're able to express our own ideas about things that can broaden not just our teaching styles. And for instance, a couple years ago, I took a student on that had autism and I hadn't really had anybody before that had that, so I had to research and it was very interesting. Now he's a great young man, he's very developed and he was never able to play any sports ever, and I was able to develop his tennis game. Now he's actually a pretty good tennis player, and socially he sort of gave him an avenue and an outlet besides a psychologist to work through his problems.
Well, it's helping out the members and helping out my team, my boss, and helping him, you know, design things and accomplish things that the club needs so that maybe I'll leave it a little better than when I found it.
Well, I've got a few things that inspire me, but the one thing that has always been my first and foremost thing that inspires me is music. Music has always inspired me. It gets me up in the morning, it gets me moving, it makes me cry, it makes me happy. It makes me feel all these emotions. Music's constantly playing in the cafe or when I'm teaching. And then I see how it makes other people feel. And that's the biggest fulfillment that I get through music. I have such a passion for people. People do inspire me a lot as well. And when I see a girl that is, or a man, who is struggling with fitness or, you know, even with food, if they don't know what to eat, if they don't know what kind of smoothie they want, if they don't know what they want to have for lunch, I like to be that person that helps them along the way.
To take something that's difficult, that has a lot of different dimensions as far as tennis development, and when those coalesce together in a really neat way, where you're taking somebody that might have some behavioral or just different weaknesses that we all have, and how you can transform their whole lives because of a simple sport like tennis is just amazing to me. And I absolutely love to be part of somebody's life where tennis is kind of an anecdote for other things in life that's on a much bigger thing. Like it's like I coach about a green fuzzy ball, but it becomes many more life skills that is just paramount in their development as a person. And I think if they can do this, there's so many other things in life that they'll be able to do.
Working in Project Walk, do you see inspiration everywhere? Everywhere on a daily basis. But when you ask me that question, what it comes to mind is seeing how a 13-year-old boy that has been dealing with an illness since he was very little comes and does his training every week. And when he comes, he doesn't come with a frown. He doesn't come complaining about anything. He comes in and he smiles.
The building relationships with other people and just interacting with people, I feel like, it's, you know, a rewarding thing for them and for you. I feel like you get a lot out of it and it's great. Like I said, every day it's a new thing. Working with different people, I get to work in different departments and deal with plenty of different personalities, and it's a great thing. You know, I feel like it's just only going to help my future. So, yeah.
I love seeing the clients and the members, and a big motivator is I have children and I want to be that example for them, to just teach them hard work does pay off. You could still work hard and be happy, and nothing in life is easy, so with all of the hardships that we all have experienced in life, you still get up, you still go every day, and you find the good in that.
When I see participants of the many programs that we offer, so whether it be a Nutrition Master Pro program, the Live Well After Cancer program, diabetes education, power plate training, Project Walk, so when I see those individuals become members or become family
and see that their quality of life has improved, that inspires me to continue to learn and grow as a professional. To see them healthy and happy and feeling like a regular, productive member of society, that inspires me to continue to learn and grow.
What inspires me is when these kids have had a long day at school and they're tired and they're exhausted and they're stressed and they've had issues at home and they're just not feeling good. They get here and most of the time they have a good attitude. These great attitudes inspires me to do my best. When they get here and they're smiling and they want to get in the water and learn and improve themselves, it makes me want to improve myself and be a better coach for them.
My family and especially my children, aside from this, you know, like looking forward to go to work every day just because this is a very family-like environment, I just, you know, my nine-year-old daughter, she'll pray every morning and she will say, when we pray, before we always pray before we go to work or where we go, let's say my kids go to school, she will pray and she will say, Jesus, help my mom to do a good job because I love, it's gonna make me cry. She was saying, I want my mom to do a good job all the time so that I can keep coming to Inzoom so she can continue to come here. And that means a lot to me. And she will always say, I hope that she will always do a good job so that me and my sister and my brother will still come and be at Kids Court and Inzoom and be at the club.
Part of what works for me being here is that the values here are, they resonate with me. I think that every one of us is given a special gift, a gift that's unique to us. And I think that we need to recognize that gift. We need to embrace that gift. We need to nurture that gift. We need to believe that gift. We need to develop and grow it. And then we need to share it. And that's exactly what's happening here. It's from the CEO to everybody that's here. We're all doing what we're good at, contributing to our community, and not just the department we're in, but the community, the culture of the club, and the city, and eventually bigger and bigger, because I think we're here to make a positive difference. And we're given a gift, and that gift comes with a responsibility, and that's to share it. It's not something you put in a treasure chest, but it's something that you develop, you believe in, and then you share it, and that's the place to do it, and I'm very happy to be here.
That was literally the most eloquent, beautiful answer I've gotten this entire week.
Thank you.
That was perfect.
That's what I believe in.
That's it.
How would you describe the atmosphere of the employees here at the Claremont Club like?
It's a very happy place to work.
I like it.